Stewart was born right here in Houston, at a time when soldiers were just coming home from World War I, Woodrow Wilson was president, television was a generation away, and like Stewart, radio was in its infancy. As a youngster, Stewart worked in the family business as an office boy and was paid the sum of $5 a week. With his earnings, he gave $1 to his church, put aside $1 for his future, and with the rest of the money, well, the rest of the money went to pay rent and buy his own clothes. Needless to say, young Stewart learned the value of hard work and an earned dollar. Stewart came to Christ early in life and was active in his church. One summer at church camp, 16-year-old Stewart Morris made the acquaintance of 13-year-old Joella Mitchell from Dallas. They would become fast friends and spent one lazy afternoon on the back of a boat, seeing who could spit watermelon seeds the farthest into the lake. It was the summer of 1935. Stewart would go on to finish high school and enroll at the University of Houston. Houston looked a little bit different back then, and to get to class, Stewart would ride his horse across town, tie up on campus, and ride home later in the evening. He finished his undergraduate work at the University of Texas and entered law school at Southern Methodist University in Dallas. And who should he meet on campus but an undergraduate named Joella Mitchell, his old friend from summer camp. It didn't take long for friendship to turn to love, and Stewart and Joella were married. War was on the horizon, and Stewart says he figured if he didn't marry her before he got drafted, she might not be available when he got back. They would be together for 70 years and 2 months. Their honeymoon, however, was much shorter. Like a lot of young men of his generation, Stewart served his country in the fight for liberty during the Second World War. He enlisted in the Navy and served on LST-38, a landing ship tank that brought men, munitions, and armor into the heart of enemy territory. He participated in 7 invasions and once rescued a downed pilot from shark-infested waters in the Pacific. I once asked Stewart what LST stood for, and he said that on a moonlit night on the Pacific Ocean, it stood for Long Slow Target. After the war, Stewart moved back to Houston, where he and Joella started a family, raising 3 children, 2 girls, and a boy. The family wasn't the only thing growing. Using what he learned in college and in the Navy, Stewart took the family business to new heights, extending the reach of Stewart Title to every state in the Union and over 7,500 offices worldwide. It was that business sense and success that led him to lead the charge for the creation of what was then Houston Baptist College. After almost a decade of planning and prayer, the school was chartered in 1960 and opened its doors in 1963 with a freshman class of 191 students and 30 faculty. The contributions of Stewart Morris and family to what is now Houston Baptist University are all around us. His fingerprints are not only on the original charter for the university, but you can see the influence of his family in the Museum of Southern History, the Morris Cultural Arts Center, and the soon-to-be-built Morris Family Center for Law and Liberty. This classroom building, modeled after Independence Hall in Philadelphia, will stand as an outward and visible symbol of all that Stewart believes in and has defended all his life. Faith in God, respect for the past, and the freedom to build your own future. Stewart is fond of saying that the world turns on personalities, and it is undoubtedly true that the history and future of Houston Baptist University have revolved around Stewart Morris.